Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install MySQL Server with MySQL Workbench, and also I'll be showing you how to run few basic commands like create, insert, update and delete. So this is going to be a beginner friendly tutorial, so let's get started. So first thing, just Google download MySQL. You'll be getting the first link, MySQL downloads. Just click this. And in this, if you just scroll down, you'll be having this MySQL community GPL downloads. Click this. And here you'll be having MySQL installer for Windows. Click this again. And you'll be taken to an interface like this. And here our version is going to be the latest one and the operating system is Windows. We have two options over here, web installer and another one is the normal installer. We'll be choosing the normal one. So just click on download. And just click just start my download, and it is about 285 MB in size, so just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just double click and open the MSI installer. So you will be getting the MySQL installer dialog box. In this, by default it will be only in server only. This won't install MySQL Workbench. So for installing both, just click on custom and just click on next. And here for installing MySQL server, click on this plus again, and you'll be having the server. Just select this and click on this green arrow. So these are the list that's going to get installed. So for Workbench, go to applications. Here we'll be having MySQL Workbench. Open it, select this and install. So in case if you want shell, same procedure also. So I'm good with this three. So just click on next and just click on execute. Just click on I agree and click on install. Just click on close. So the installation is done for everything. Just click on next and just click on execute. So once you get the status as complete for all, just click on next. Next again. So this is going to be the default port. I would ask you to like leave it to the default one. Don't change anything over here. Just click on next. Next again. And here you'll be having a default root password. Make sure that you remember this. Okay, so I will just type my password on next. So this is fine. Everything is good. And again, click on next and click on execute. So once everything is done, you'll be getting MySQL server was successfully installed. So just click on finish and just click on next. So this is fine. You can just click on finish by checking this too. So you'll be getting an interface like this. This is MySQL Workbench, and by default you'll be getting a connection over here. I didn't create this one. So just double click over here and you need to type the password that you gave when installing MySQL. So I'll just type that password and you can even like save it in the vault. Just click on OK. This is the MySQL Workbench interface, and in case if you're getting some errors, no connection established, what you need to do is you need to just go to search and you need to type for services, open it, and in the services you need to just scroll down till M. You'll be having this MySQL 8080. So if the service is not running, you may get any errors. For me it is running now, so just start the service if this isn't running. Close it now, and this is the MySQL shell. You can just try running here any MySQL query. I'll close this also. So now the final thing is we need to check if our MySQL queries are working. So let me just, you know, just run a simple query of creating a database. So it's going to be create database. Yeah, this is going to be my query, and if I just run it, I'll be getting a green mark. And if I go to schemas and refresh this, here you can see I'm having a database named hello. So now that we have successfully installed and set up MySQL server and Workbench, let's go and run some MySQL queries. So the first thing is the font size. I've just changed my font size. So I will show you how you can do this also. So for this, to the top, you will be having this option called as edit. Click that, go to preferences. And in this, you'll be having here fonts and colors. Click this, and I would ask you to have the font size as 40 or 50, because you know the default font size is so small. So you can just like change it this way for everything. And just click on OK. And after this, you want to just restart your connection. Click here. So this is how you change the font size. So now we are going to see the query for these five operations, which are going to be create, insert, select, update, and delete. So now we have created a database. So we are now inside this Hello database. And inside the database, we'll be creating a table. So the query is going to be create space table. This can be in smaller or capital letters or even both mix. That's totally up to you. Space. Next is going to be the table name. I'll just give it as table one. So this is going to be my table name, and open circular bracket. And within this, we need to specify our column name and the data type of our column. So I'm just going to have two columns. One is going to be the ID, which is going to be of data type integer or numbers. And next column name is going to be name, which is going to be of type varchar, which is also called a string. So its string is called as varchar over here. So if you don't have space, you can just go to the next line. It's going to be varchar, and within bracket, you can specify the number of letters. Let me go with 20. We need to end with the bracket, okay? Make sure that you are having the right number of brackets. And you can come to the next line if you don't have space. That's totally fine. So this will create a table of two columns named ID and name. So I will just run this. For running this query, just select this and click on this run button. And here you can see we are getting an error. And the error says no database selected, okay? So the reason is because after changing the font, we actually restarted our MySQL Workbench connection. So every time you come inside your MySQL Workbench, you need to choose a database to use. So for this, you need to just run the command use the database name. So in our case, we just created a database named Hello earlier. So we need to use that name over here. So it's going to be use Hello. So you need to use this. So if I just now run this, here you can see we are getting a green mark. This command indicates that we are going to use this database and we are going to create a table inside this database named Hello. So just imagine, right, if you go and directly run a command inside MySQL Workbench without even specifying a database, MySQL Workbench will be just confused, okay? We don't know which database we are going to create this new table. So that's the reason why we need to specify the database that we are going to use at first when you are coming inside your MySQL Workbench connection. So now we can run this command. So here you can see we are getting command executed, a green color sign. So if I go inside this Hello, which is our database, just refresh this and go inside this tables, we'll be having table one. And if I expand this also, if I go inside columns, we'll be having ID and name, which is the name that we have given over here. Now we are good with creating a table. We have created it. We are having the ID and name. Next thing is going to be the insert. So the query is quite same. It's going to be insert into table name. We are not going to have insert into table and table name. It's just going to be table name. So I'll just copy my table name over here and space values. So many people forget the values thing. So values keyword should come over there. Next thing is the circular bracket. And within this, we need to specify the values that you're going to insert for the column within comma. So first is going to be the ID, which is of type int. So let me have it as one, comma, and next is going to be the name, which is of type string. So that should come within double quotes. So I'll just go with John. So this is going to be the query, insert into table name, values, one, and John. And one shouldn't come within double quotes because it is of type integer. So two columns, two values, all right. So select this and run it. So we'll be getting inserted. If I go with two and if I just change this to some other name and run this, we'll be getting again inserted. So now we have inserted two values, but we want to see the rows and columns, how it looks in a table format. So for that, we'll be using the select query. So for that, it's straightforward. It's going to be select asterisk from table name. So it's going to be table one. So this will display the entire table. Okay, I'm selecting this and running. So here you can see this is our table. As I told you, ID and name are the columns, and these two rows are the value that we inserted right now. So if you want to close this view, you can just click on this close button. And in case if you want to view only the name or ID, you don't want to view the entire table or a specific column, okay, what you can do is, rather than having here asterisk, you can just specify the column name. So we're having ID and name columns, right? You can just specify here, select name. So this will display the name column alone. So if I run this, only name column, and if you put ID over here, you'll be able to view only the first column or the ID column. So by this way, you can change this. And next is going to be the update. So for writing the update query, we will be having a condition. All right. So I'll just view the table. So how update works is that, let's suppose say that I want to change the name from John to some other else. So how this will work is that we will be using a condition as ID equal to 1. So for updating a particular row, we need to have a unique identifier that identifies a row or multiple number of rows. So I'll just write the query and later explain it. So it's going to be, as usual, the update keyword, update the table name and set. So this is also like an important keyword. We need to have the column name which you want to change. So in my case, as I told you, I want to change the name John, which is present inside the column named name, equal to, so this is going to have the alter name or the name that you want to change. So I'll just have with JJJ something like this, such a random name, equal to, as I told you, we'll be having a where condition, where ID equal to 1. So the same thing that I told you, I'm going to replace the name John or update the name John with some other name that I'm giving over here, and I'm identifying to change only John and not Dan by using the command var ID equal to 1. So if I don't give this, all the names will be getting changed, and this is going to be the name that I'm going to replace over John. Okay, so this is the command, update table name, set column name of that value we are going to update. The value itself you need to assign like this, the where condition to identify uniquely, where ID, the name of the column that we have, ID equal to 1. So I'm asking MySQL to only change this name where ID is 1. Alright, so if I just now run this, we are getting an error. You are using safe update mode. So that's the reason why it is throwing us an error. So to solve this issue, what you need to do is go to edit, preferences, and you'll be having this SQL editor. Okay, just click this and scroll down, you'll be having this safe updates. Okay, rejects updates and deletes with no restriction. You need to just uncheck this and click on OK. And after doing this, make sure that you are restarting your MySQL workbench. So I have restarted my MySQL workbench now. And if I run this command, we'll be getting an error again. It will say no database is selected. Okay, so no database selected. So this is the reason why we need to use this use hello. Okay, so whenever you restart, we need to select a database. So if I run this, yeah, now we are good. And now if I go and run this update query, here you can see we are getting a green mark. And if I go to my table and view the content, here you can see our name John has been replaced. So what if I want to replace an entire column itself? So I want to replace every name present in my table. So in that case, what we can do is we can just remove this where condition itself. So what it does is that this particular update will work for all the values present inside name column. So I'll just go with some random name like this. So if I run this, and if I view the table, here you can see all the name has changed because I'm not having here any where condition, which means that it will apply for all the rows irrespective of the IDs. Okay, so in case we want a specific ID, you need to have an ID over there. So final thing is going to be the delete query. So it's going to be delete from table name, and similar to update, we'll be having the where clause, where the column name that uniquely references your row. In my case, it's ID, ID equal to 1. Okay, so this will basically delete the first row. So we won't be having a row with ID 1. So if I just run this, green mark, and if I go to select table, here you can see ID 1 is removed from our table itself. So these are some of the basic queries that you use in MySQL, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of complex queries in MySQL, as well as other programming videos and CRUD operations using MySQL, Node.js, Spring Boot, MongoDB also. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.